everybody, this is Lollipop081. I'm LE here today, and welcome to another episode of Lollipop Speed Art. Now, we're continuing with the historical Disney here, and this was my second entry for Disney Club's historical Disney contest, their group contest going on DeviantArt. So this was my second entry, and if you can tell by the title, I did one of the most, actually the most underrated Disney female in history. Her name is Eilonwy. And if you guys have probably been living under a rock, she's from The Black Cauldron, Disney's adaptation of the book series The Chronicles of Prydeine. And this film came out in 1985 during the Disney Dark Age, where Disney began to lose its magical touch after Walt's passing in 1966. Although there were some hits in the 70s, but the 80s were considered a dark period. And shift in management, and of course Jeffrey Katzenberg and Michael Eisner joined during the time when this film was released. Now, I want to go here and tell you, having her hold her hands out, that was supposed to like be her holding her, her bauble here, was difficult to do. So anyways, The Black Cauldron, a lot of people, that film was a flop, and Eilonwy was not made a Disney princess, although I wish she was. So anyways, I rewatched the film recently on Disney Plus. It actually went to Disney Plus before it got a HD remaster for Blu-ray. So I made it onto Disney Plus. So I rewatched it with the whole I'm an adult. The last time I watched this film was when I was a child. And I have to say, yes, it's still Disney's most underrated animated feature in the canon. The Horned King is a spectacular villain, and the portrayal by John Hurt, who was also, you know him more as Ollivander in the Harry Potter films, and also the War Doctor in Doctor Who 50th anniversary special, Day of the Doctor. Rest in peace to him. The animation is pretty good, and this is one of the first films to showcase CGI, as we all know. And yeah, even though it's not looking the greatest, but this was the first animated film to showcase it. And then you got The Great Mouse Detective and Oliver and Company that would do it years later. And then, of course, you got the Disney Renaissance with The Little Mermaid all the way to Tarzan. So anyways, I chose the Normandy era for Eilonwy simply because the film takes place in the early Middle Ages. And I was thinking to myself, should I go for Anglo-Saxon, as in during like the 9th and 10th century when England became, well, England was united, or go for the Norman Conquest and William the Conqueror and Empress Matilda? I went with the latter, and next the difficult task was trying to get her color scheme perfect. Oh, and by the way, I also made Eilonwy a strawberry blonde, so to speak, mainly because in the books, which I would love to read, she was portrayed as a golden redhead with bright blue eyes, or light blue eyes, I believe. And in the film, she has blonde hair and light blue eyes. And she was made to look like Aurora. I'm serious. She was made to look exactly like one of the famous Disney princesses. So what I did here is I made her girdle blue, like her top of her original outfit, and the red boning part down the middle was red, so I did it for her collar and her belt. I gave her pink wide sleeves. I added a slight puff to it. She has a white long-sleeved chemise. She also has a pink cotton veil over her hair, because she, even though she's still showing her hair and whatnot, with her black circlet. And she also has a pink cloak with white fur trim because, again, she is a princess after all. And really, the biggest criticisms I have with the film is that the story needed more work. And of course, like, the crap that went on with the change of management at Disney and whatnot. Jeffrey Katzenberg! Anyways, sorry about that. And there were a lot of scenes that were, many scenes that were completed for the film, but they were deleted. They were cut. Why? Because these scenes contain, mature content. Like, mature content, literally. Oh, and I added her in a forest here. I want to go in a little bit more detail in the comments below, but anyways, I hope you enjoyed this. Please subscribe, ring the bell for notifications as I post videos like this and Lollipop Sings and Lollipop Discusses every Fridays and Saturdays. And don't forget to follow me on my social media page, Twitter, Instagram, Reddit, and DeviantArt at Lollipop081MLE, as where the final piece is. I will see you next time, my peeps. Peace, y'all!